Well, boss, I've uncovered some frightening news. There's a maniac running around. I've been finding all these dead bodies with gunshot wounds and impacts on their forehead and all sorts of chaos and destruction and whatnot. There's a maniac behind this, and I won't stop until I find them. When we find them, we've got to put them right in jail. Boss? Boss, I don't like the way you're looking at me. Alright. We're going to jail. And hopefully the easy way. So, we've shown off how, even though we are using the gun and a lot of similar cards to what we were using in that prior run, the context has changed entirely because of this combo system that we're actually making full use of. So I am hoping that we can get some combo, maximum combo up to make these cards even more powerful than they are now. Now, do we want to use quick draw or do we want to draw and get something else? We're going to have to start thinking about the number of projectiles we're outputting, particularly insofar as we can kill the cutthroat efficiently, because even though he's not that much of a threat on his own, his ability to just make the other enemies that much tougher to counter is certainly a headache. So, we'll see. What sorts of things could we be drawing? Once again, there's a thrown gun. Even if we get that, that's not so bad. Because at worst, that's only, that would be 6 damage instead of 8. So, it's actually probably not that bad. Yeah, let's see what we get. This is going to be a turn where having that extra momentum might help, and just being able to throw out something at 0 momentum could make a difference. Or we could just do holster. Like, we could just start building our combo, and that's fine, too. Do you want to double tap and then holster, and then quick draw and flourish or something? Well, it's too late to flourish now. Like, that's not happening. We're just trying to maximize our damage now at this point, so I think just whiffing 8 damage on you is okay. Yeah, kind of a weird snapback there, but has to be done. He has to react to that second shot. And it's not like we're going to do a special case where we track him for the second shot. That would be a little bit weird. So I guess what we're doing now is holstering and then quick drawing and then shifting out of the way. We might get something better, but if not, then that's what we're doing. I'll get a different quick draw. We could try swapping and shifting instead. The quick draw only does 12, whereas this guy does 14, so this is another way of getting the job done. Otherwise, we don't have any proper gunshot cards to play, like flourish linking into a shot, so that's just simply not what we drew. So, sure, let's put swap to use. I like swap. Hopefully, at some point we'll upgrade swap to do 0 momentum, and we'll hopefully we can do that before we get into one of those critical missions, but we'll see. We'll get there when we get there. We're maintaining good board position. There we go. 3-punch combo is great at dealing with this guy. Now we only whiff 3 damage, and we still get most of that to go through. What's the rest of our turn look like? We can draw with countershot. That sounds good. Actually, since we can't move, we probably should figure out how to kill you at least. We could right spin kick you. That'll deal with you. But I think we can get you killed. On the other hand, as I've talked about before in the past, if I can quick shot through you, then that means that instead of whiffing like a 3 damage punch, the shot actually will go through you and still do something productive at the other end. So what would that look like? I could do counter shot, quick shot through you, burn the dodge, but it goes to you. Could I do 3-punch combo And quick shot, that's 9 and 8 is 17, so that's not quite enough to kill you. But the counter shot itself could. That would be fine. Yeah, I'm planning on standing there with counter shot, so just counter shotting you for 18 means I only have to do 2 damage to you. So 3 punch combo takes care of that, then everything else is on you. That's pretty good. So what would that look like? That would look like counter shot, quick shot through you, 3 punch combo, quick strike you, and then right spin kick. I think that all works. And then I just don't throw gun, which is fine. I mean, I like doing that, but I don't need to do that every time. There we go. Even when you dodge, you still lay the seeds of your own destruction. You can't help it. It's in your nature. Yeah, these are my attacks, so I guess we'll do 8 to you and 9 to you rather than the other way around. Okay, that works. Now we can counter you guys easier on the next turn. I don't know if your damage has grown enough. Oh, it's still possible to do cleanly on this turn, so that's good. What else can we do in the meantime? Any of you at the point where I can kill you? Not quite. Quick draw will take care of you. And the swap will work, so yeah, that's pretty solid. So something to, like, just quick draw to kill you, swap, counter shot, and then both the counter shot and you take care of you. And that's pretty efficient, too. So first we do the quick draw, then we do the counter shot, and then we swap. So you can see how much just incredible amounts of work we're getting done. Even now, even with barely any upgrades, even with only 3 momentum, this deck is only going to get crazier after that. So I'm just hoping that I can get enough strength so that we can get that critical 4th momentum going. Okay, now this is a bit of a weird turn where we have 4 things that need our gun and no way of drawing the gun other than draw. We're not getting anything done this turn unless we do that, so I guess that's what we're doing. We're doing it. Too bad about throw gun, but oh well. And we can holster again once that's all done, and I suppose we will. Yeah, throw gun only works on you. Like, you're too close, so I guess we're gonna do double tap. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Double tap, quick shot into throw gun, and actually that kills you, because we built up enough combo again. It's like a little tiny hammer fist. And I could hit him even though he's 3 tiles away. What if there was a guy all the way over there and I wanted to hammer fist him? What then? Both of these could be okay. I might reasonably take a shimmy and see if I can get some value out of that. It's not quite as crazy as it was prior to the Weapon of Choice DLC. They fixed the dodge carrying over between turns, but it's still a good card. Yeah, that's reasonable. If there's a briefcase, we want to be able to get to that as soon as possible. And although this doesn't let us move through enemies, it might not let us move after we've gotten the enemies out of our way. So even though it's only 1 tile of movement, it's 1 pretty good tile of movement. Brass knuckles or palm strike. Now that we've taken an extra movement, maybe we can get a little bit greedy again and take one of those. We have 2 things that do multi-hit, and having a melee attack where we can just increase the damage value of all this stuff is awful tempting. Brass knuckles I might take if I had 4 momentum, but I think it's a little bit too early now. Like, if I had multiple quick shots, brass knuckles and quick shot is actually hilarious. You can get a lot of work done with that, but I feel like you really need to upgrade Brass Knuckles in order to make it worthwhile, worth that one momentum and card cost, and it's not very good before then. Basic Palm Strike is a lot better than basic Brass Knuckles. That's my rationale here. And I can take the Palm Strike because I took the Shimmy. I think I would be a lot more leery of doing that if I was still stuck at 3 movement, but with 4, I think I can do that. And that gives me, like, now I can do 3-punch combo and Palm Strike that go together great, and now we can start thinking about getting rid of Quick Strike. So, now these things work together that much better. Oh, making me choose. I think I still have to take the early momentum. I mean, it's not often that you get this choice right at the start, but I think I've got to go for it. We can wait on 12 combo, but if we get that 4th momentum now, like right now, the rest of this ought to be a cakewalk, right? Hopefully we can move. Yes, we can. Alright. Collect a briefcase in 5 turns. That is tough, but we can do it. I'd like to go this way. Can we go this way? I would probably take the 6 damage right on the head. If we can figure out a clean way of going there. Quick draw is probably not in the cards. I'm planning on double tapping with that momentum, basically. So, sure, we will draw instead. We're not killing you at range. So, probably instead what we are doing is something like double tap. Flourish throw gun, maybe? No, but we want to be able to right spin kick you when we get there. I think that's the trick. So we won't flourish. Yeah, okay. I will absolutely take the 6 damage in service of this. However, wait a minute. We can throw gun into quick draw. Hold on. Hold the phone. This works. Take that. I'm not out of guns. I have another gun. Don't forget, we have an infinite number of guns. There we go. That's more like it. Okay, we can get a lot of work done now this time. We can just barrel right on through and countershot to cover our exit, right? Or if we can figure out a way to kill you, then we can just go right on through. How's this? Quick draw into quick shot is 28. And that's only one momentum, so shift and 3-punch combo. 28 and 9 is 37, and you only have 34 health. Fancy that. Would you look at that? So, what we could do first is try shift 3-punch combo and see what our quick draw looks like after that. So that's minus 1 plus 3, so we'd be at 8 combos. So we do 9 damage, and we would be doing 4 more than this. So 9 and 24 is 33, which is not enough. Just barely. Just barely. So, yeah, we can't play... Well, we can play... We can only play Quick Shot after we've played either Quick Draw or Counter Shot. So, yeah, we're not going to cleanly kill you with just 3-punch combo and Quick Draw. But I don't have to play 3-punch combo. So I could do some... Oh. No, let's not get ahead of ourselves. We have to play one momentum of counter shot in order to deal with this coming back here. Unless we want to ignore it, which technically we could, but that is a lot of damage. I'd prefer just not to take it. What I am concerned about is just winding up on top of you, but I think that might just be unavoidable. I think. 32... I think I could accept something like quick draw into quick shots. No, I can't tackle unless I play shift. So this is effectively like 12 damage for 2 momentum, which is not very good. Like, I'm almost better off playing the 3-punch combo against you to build up my quick draw. Then that gets up to 26, and then 26 and A is 34, and that's numbers. That is number Wang right there. So that would look like 3-punch combo, quick draw, counter shot. There's my 3 momentum, quick shot, and then we just let you hit me backwards once. And I think that's okay. Even though I'm not using the shift or the tackle, I still move one towards the briefcase, and I just outright kill the enemy in my way. And that seems pretty good. I think I can do that. Quick draw first, while we can, quick shot. And now counter shot. There we go. And we get some bonus damage on you while we're at it. You're nearly dead. Sure, absolutely. Yes. No problem. And do we want to holster again now? What would you even get? That would be good. We have a dodge, so if we drew... Well, we need a zero-cost movement, so thus another good reason to upgrade swap at some point. But do we want to cycle our deck? I think not. Like, there's plenty of good stuff that we would want to draw later that we don't want to draw now, so let's just wait here. We'll distract him into this column. No, he won't. Why is he over there? Huh. Weird, but okay. I mean, counter shot will take care of him, thanks to both counter shot being amazing. Like, this is another good reason to upgrade it, is so that you can do this. 8+4. Or we could just kill him. I mean, it's really just a matter of taste, but, hey, we'll do, we're not even gonna risk him loading up the, specialty slugs in there. We'll just kill him. Okay, so we, turns to completion 4. We actually just killed everybody before the briefcase time limit, so I guess we're doing good. Here's even more movement if I want it. This is, the lousy special movement, but it's at least a way of getting away from the hatchet guy and the upgraded rifle guy, rifle assassin. I think we can live without that. I think Shimmy is basically going to do the same thing for us. So even though it costs 1 momentum, we can put that to greater use than that. We've got things to do. Fun things to do. So now that we have 4 momentum, now we're not in quite as much of a hurried upgrade swap. Maybe we upgrade something like... Do we want all our cards to be a little bit better, or do we want something that improves the flow of our, whole thing? Or do we just want to... Yeah, so do we remove Quick Strike, or do we upgrade Palm Strike? I guess that's the question. Honestly, it might be remove Quick Strike. Like, Quick Strike is a good thing to do on the first turn, but so is 3-Punch Combo. Yeah, I think I would much rather more consistently have the 3-Punch Combo and Palm Strike coming up more often, and just do all the things that do more damage than Quick Strike more often. Yeah, I think that's the play. Alright, you were a good early game pick, Quick Strike, but now we've got bigger fish to fry. We just got to the canteen just in the nick of time, and they're already out of meatloaf. That's too bad. I guess we're just doing 3-punch combo into quick draw into counter shot, and what we should be able to do something else with our momentum. There goes both of our shifts already. Do we want to attack you or attack you? We've got 3 attacks. I should probably just kill the shotgun prisoner while I've got the chance. Yeah, this is fine. It's not super exciting, but it's better than nothing. I feel like I want to use that 4th momentum right away, but honestly, just managing to kill a shotgun prisoner on the first turn is just reward enough itself. Actually, you are going first, so I will actually need to use that fourth momentum to get away from you, so... yeah, so that is actually worthwhile. Oh, hold on. You're going to move. If I move back here so I counter you, then you're going to approach me and hit me again. Which, will proc the bleed. So that's no good. I guess I can go over here. I'll counter you over here. So, maybe I could have... What? Why'd you go that way? Neither of these guys are attacking me. You should have just stayed right there and turned to face me. Is it because you were standing next to the void and you care about that, even though it's, a sideways void and not a head-on void? Is that why you did that? Man, I don't know. Aggressive enemies. Sometimes you just can't tell what they're thinking. I feel like I've got a pretty good handle on them most of the time, but even then they still mess me up every now and then, just by doing something I didn't expect them to do. Anyway, we'll probably get out of this situation with a good tackle, I imagine. Yeah, we've got good options here, and now we'll actually be able to use that four momentum. I'm just trying to figure out what order I want to do things in. If I can get you killed off, that would be great, but I wouldn't necessarily count on that. Hold on. If I can trust you, which I don't know if I can, I'm spotting something here. If I do swap here with you, you should stay here. Then if I shimmy, you should go back here, hopefully. Hopefully, I'm banking on that. And then I could tackle you out the door. So I could kill you with 3 momentum, and that's way more efficient than ever trying to grind down that 60 HP. Then I could do something like quick draw here to just get some damage in. That would be pretty good. And I'd just deal with you guys later. I think that should work, and the only other outcome I can think of where, like, when I go back here, either he will go here and get tackled, or he'll stay here and get punched. And I hope he cooperates. But if he doesn't, then I guess I can live with that. Alright, come here, you. Thank you. Now, we are perilously standing in front of the door ourselves, but I'm sure we'll be fine, right? I'm sure we'll be fine, right? Well, if we just kill you, that would work. I'm thinking something like... Flourish Quick Shot Holster? Like, that's clearly what's happening here. We're relying on Holster to, rescue us from this one, and then draw if we have to. So, that's just how this is gonna work. So, there's two ways we can fix this. Either we can kill you, or we draw something that fixes the situation. So, let's start with a flourished quick shot. I think that makes sense. Then holster, and either holster will give us something, or hopefully draw will give us just a gunshot that kills you. Quick draw will work. Yeah, quick draw will work very well. In fact, we can even link quick draw into double tap. So we can... It doesn't matter what order we really do this in. So let's get the palm strike while we can... Then we're quick drawing one and double tapping the other, and it really doesn't matter which. In fact, we drew our shift, so we can even do a little bit better than that. So, that's how this game goes sometimes. It's pretty all or nothing, I kind of feel like. There are some cases where you will get taken down by attrition. But there are definitely a lot of cases where you're just kind of on a knife's edge and you're just kind of facing either instant death on the one hand or glorious, glorious results if you actually manage to survive. And it can be very unclear which you are going to get until the last minute. Let's see if we can get movement out of Holster. I would very much like to be able to make this work. You're kind of awkwardly out of the way, but we'll see. Yeah, we can holster into counter shot. So that's how we can do something like holster, get a second movement card, then counter shot, and then throw gun, for example. That's what I'm fishing for here. Shimmy is enough. Okay, there we go. We can even get a little bit more of our combo back. We can even quick shot. Hey, buddy, catch. Hey, you're supposed to... Oh, we even can quick draw again. Why not? There we go. So there we go. Just put our gun back and forth. Put it away, put it back, throw it away, get a new one. And somehow the game is rewarding us for all of this. Here's better Nerve Strike. It does activate auto attacks, so you still have to be careful about that if you're standing in range of that, but -4 damage modifier, that adds up quite a lot. And against the likely targets you would want to apply that to, that is great. This thing, if you build around it properly, can single-handedly make the final boss encounter a joke. That said, taking it this early, we would really be leaning into it a lot, and I kind of feel like we took the Palm Strike instead. Like, that's kind of in that slot as just like a 1-1 range utility option. I feel like that would kind of be stuffing our deck a little bit too full with 1-1 range options. So, although it can be a good thing to take, I think Tackle, 3-Punch combo, and Palm Strike, and Right Spin Kick, those four cards are kind of doing that job enough. So we'll stick with it. This is good on a different run, it's just not the run we're doing. Iron Body can be hilarious. Dealing 4 damage to self, that is less damage than the aforementioned, well not aforementioned, but we've seen examples of how Blood Fury, that's the word. That card dealing 6 damage to you can still be sustainable. This is a different kind of sustainability, but it only helps you on 2 turns instead of for the rest of the entire fight. So, it's still good. I don't think we're necessarily built around it. It's good. If I were still in the phase of adding more stuff to my deck, I'd consider it, but again, I'd like to just see where this goes. I'm hoping that Shimmy and Countershot do enough by themselves. Like, I have 3 block cards. Like, I have a block, I have 2 things that block, and I have 1 thing that dodges. That's pretty good. That's a pretty good sign. I've got my bases covered. If I didn't have anything at all that blocked, then I would take this. Okay, well, we get combo either which way we go. So we could take an informant mission, which is usually not that bad, or a mystery event. And I'm just going to take the informant mission. This is a little bit of a tricky map to go with, particularly since this tunnel here can be awkward to work with as far as pushing enemies out the door, but it's still one of the easier fights in the game, and adding on this guy into it does not make it that much harder. So case in point, we can easily get away from this. It's just a question of where do we want to put our various damage. There's throw gun. I'd like to kill you cleanly, and I guess we can do that with something like 3-punch combo, quick shot, and tackle. Then right spin kick you. I'm not going to be able to easily damage you this turn, but I'm not sure how much I need to be concerned about that in this particular case. If I kill you, then I believe the next guy up, who would normally have already showed up, but you took a spot, the next guy would be an auto attack guy who's much more of a hassle than you are, so I might actually just want to keep you around for the time being. Like, just focus on damaging you as much as possible, then just exit by tackling you. I think I can live with that. So that looks something like holster now, and maybe I can get something else that attacks you. Yeah, like this stuff. This counts. Quick draw. Yeah, and then I can do right spin kick. Perfect. And all this, these are super cheap options too. Like, they are not expensive in the slightest. Sadly, I don't think I can both tackle and throw gun. So I guess that means I'm throwing, backing up and throwing gun. Okay. Cool. Yeah. He is unamused. But also possibly mildly concussed. We'll see. Alright, well, I think you can just get out. Alright, informant, help me out. Alright, you take care of him. I'm going over here. Quick draw into... flourish into... double tap. That man is extremely dead. Alright, finish him off. Thanks. Appreciate you and your forehead taking one for the team there. Don't you just love it when you and the informant are on the same side? When you know exactly what each other are thinking? When you have each other's backs? It's glorious. Don't need any of this stuff. Yeah, we're really gonna be looking scornfully on any, unupgraded cards from this point forward. Unless they're really good. We're gonna start skipping a lot of these things. Because we're doing good. This is a good deck. It's scaring us a little bit. It is actually getting us in a little bit of trouble sometimes, but we are going places with it. Oh, perfect. I'll tell you what. Yeah, let's get our palm strike played. On the other hand, if we do want to do our maximum distance movement, that is three momentum, swap, shift, shift, but that gets us all the way there. I think it still works, though. Yeah, we have four momentum, so we can play double tap and still do swap, shift, shift. So we can do something like double tap, swap, palm strike, and quick shot. And now you're not going to be covering the briefcase anymore. And we'll just zoom all the way over here. No one's getting our way now. I'm excited. This is working. This is working out pretty well, if I do say so myself. So, how greedy do we want to be? The greedy play is shimmying forward, ignoring this attack, and then right spin kicking him right out the door so I can get this taken care of. Problem is, that puts us at risk of not being able to get to the briefcase in time. So, the more conservative play is to just probably right spin kick you and shoot you, and then just go back and get the case now. Worry about this objective later. Yeah, how much movement do we have coming up? Do we have a shift? No, we've got four cards. This is guaranteed to be... all this stuff is guaranteed to not be movement, and then it's one random card from the rest of our deck, which is mostly not movement. So, if we do that, if we go forward here, we are probably not moving next turn. So, because of that, I don't want to go here. If I knew that one of these four cards was a movement, then that'd be another story. I'd be guaranteed to have a shift and go here. But because we drew all our movement ahead of time and took advantage of it just now, we don't have it later, which is understandable, entirely understandable. What we can do is get slightly fancy here and do something like right spin kick and let him kick us into the briefcase. So we'll do that via quick draw into counter shot. and he'll come forward and kick us, and we'll shoot him, and then the riot shield guy gets him, and everybody just beats each other up. As pictured here. Oh yeah, that went without comment, but the right spin kick actually did do full damage to this guy. It didn't used to. It used to just consider what direction you and the riot shield prisoner were from each other and which direction this guy was facing. So the direction of the right spin kick damage was effectively forward into his shield. Now I believe the way that works for right spin kick and shove is... for right spin kick, it would look like it's coming from his left. So it will actually go around his shield if he's facing you. But that can lead to some weird behavior if he's facing away from you, and you need to be careful about what direction you attack him from. So still be mindful of that. Let's see, where are we? Now we need to work on getting enemies out of the board. And... we don't have a lot of good tools for that. We could draw some, though. Waiting right here is with Counterstun is actually not that bad of an idea either. But maybe we can be a little bit more proactive about things. Maybe we can draw a right spin kick again. That could happen. It's possible. There it is. Okay, as promised. So we'll shift through. We'll do our right spin kick now. Or do we want to do the palm strike? Do I want to just kill this guy off? I know if we kill too efficiently, like if we kill you, and you, we've seen demonstrations that this guy is suddenly, if he's the last guy left, he becomes afraid of the void and won't step next to it. So let's not be too eager of just killing absolutely everybody off. I think we can achieve a fair balance by, actually not palm striking, if you can believe it. All we're going to do is right spin kick and quick draw and call it a day, because actually leaving both of these guys alive at full health will make it easier to push a second guy out of the board. So that's all we'll do. It's enough. And I could throw gun at you maybe if I want to kill you slightly faster, but the reason I'm leaving you alive at full health is so that it's actually easier for me to, say, right spin kick you around. I should remind myself also that tackle and right spin kick are the only ways I have of getting people off the board, so I should plan with that in mind. It was honestly kind of a big break that even worked as well as it did. I think what I want to do here is swap and tackle and try and put you next to the railing, and then maybe I can cycle my deck fast enough. If I can cycle, then maybe next turn I can draw the right spin kick and just kick you off that way. And because I'll have tackled you and you'll be busy getting up, you won't be able to move away no matter what. No matter what your preferences are. So if that's what we're going for, then cycling the deck, we want to draw now. So that at least gives us a chance of drawing the right spin kick next turn. And we'll want to have the combo to play it, of course, so let's give ourselves some combo. There we go. And I guess if not, then probably... pre-damaging you a little bit makes sense, but that's what tackle is doing. Okay. Okay, let me see if my strategy works out. Is the game going to reward me? Yes, it is. So there you go. Another excellent use of draw, for once. Turning my discard pile into my draw pile, which makes it possible that even though I drew right spin kick on the previous turn, I can draw it again because I've reshuffled the whole thing. So I can play it two turns in a row. There we go. So we'll just quick draw and holster and quick draw again. Is that the same gun? Is it two different guns? Who knows? Even the security cameras are gonna have a hard time figuring that one out. Alright, I know exactly what I see here. Fresh meat. I think we'll want to end things out by shifting and countershotting. Shift over here and countershot. So we've got 18 lined up on you already. Can we do 17 cleanly? We can do 16. We can do 24, and that's probably close enough. Throw gun. How much damage is throw gun going to do if I do these first? It will be 6 plus 6 is 12. And we're hunting for a 17, so quick shot and throw gun on you kills you. Then double tap gets you most of the way there. Additionally, we have counter stun. That doesn't do any more damage, but we get it for free, so it gets us some more combo at least. Okay. Now at this point, I think all that really did was just tick him off. I'm just encouraging him to attack me by throwing the gun at him. Yeah, I'm right here. Come get me. And there we go. Oh, we've drawn two. We're a victim of our own success. We've drawn two quick draws. We can't play both of them. That's a pity. You actually are gonna play a pretty integral role in this whole thing, because what I can do is make you responsible for catapulting this guy out of the way, and then I can just go to town on him. I can clean you up later, right? Yeah, this is just gonna be an excellent turn for just, doing a little bit of the old myrtleizing here. Just a little bit of the old-fashioned murder, just like Grandma used to make. There we go. Help me out here. Put the finishing touch on this. Put the cherry on the cake. There we go. Thanks, buddy. Alright, you are rewarded as a traitor deserves. There you go. And we're already cleaning up. I was a little bit worried we'd be running into one of those kitchen or canteen missions where there was a lieutenant and like 6 or 7 enemies and a really tight time limit. That is extremely nasty on brutal mode, as I'm sure I will get a chance to demonstrate at some point, but we aren't quite there quite yet. I think I'm doing this flourish and holster sequence more so to for drawing more cards more than to for the damage, but that's alright. I'm okay with spending a little bit of combo just to do card draw. Because we could get quick draw. There we go. And the smaller I make my deck, the more often that will happen. Oh, game. You are tempting me. Now you're giving me the good stuff. Power Sink, Hammer Fist. Power Sink is tempting, but honestly, I don't think we really need it. Like, we have Palm Strike, we have Counter Shot. We're having trouble with getting enough card draw. Like, now I'm on the lookout for more holsters, more, like, a Ponder or Foresight at this point would be amazing. I'd love to find one of those. So I think getting one of these, like, getting a Power Sink, getting a Hammer Fist, is kind of putting the cart before the horse here. I don't think we need an upgraded Hammer Fist. These quick draws are doing plenty fine on their own. This is about the right level of greed. Having three combo-fueled things that occasionally link into one another. Not always, but sometimes. It's amusing when it does happen. Honestly, as crazy as it is, I'm gonna turn down an upgraded Hammer Fist because I don't think we need it. I think we're fine. Now, do I want a fifth momentum, or do I want to start going to the gym and, get a combo upgrade, get some more core upgrades. If we go this way, oh, it's 2 momentum. Well, hang on. Are these the same map? I guess they are. One of these is going to be with the assassins, and then one of them is going to be without. But I can't say no to having six momentum, right? Like, that just increases the amount of utter nonsense we can get up to. And it'll certainly make life easier if I just don't have to care about how much momentum I have left over. I can just play my cards and not have to worry about it. Except in the rare occasions where I will have to worry about it. Naturally, but anyhow. Let's see, so we actually have quite a lot of good stuff here. I could do counter shot, counter stun, shimmy to pretty good effect here. And I think that would mean you would attack first, so I think, like, if I'm shimmying this way, I think you would attack first, and I would actually get my counter stun and counter shot off. You know, the 14 damage on you wouldn't do anything, but that's alright. Then I would be in the way, so then I would absorb that 14 with block and bump into you for even more damage. So everything would happen exactly the way I would want it to. So, yeah, that seems pretty good. I like that combination. Okay, all of that with just a few actions, and yet, we can keep going. So your attack's all used up, I don't have to worry about you anymore. Who am I killing? I could kill either you or you. That is an excellent choice to have to choose between. I think I choose you. You've done the criminal tactic of annoying me, so you get to live a little while longer, and now we can get some friendly fire set up with maximum damage among the group. And maybe I can right spin kick you off the ledge at some point or another. We'll see. Now we're just gonna get things started off just right. How would I like to do this? I could draw, like, that is an option. As much as I enjoy having 9 combo, I might enjoy having guns even more. Like, just the guarantee of being able to do 20 damage and whatever I draw. Yeah, we can get that 2 combo back, no problem. Sure, no problem. Just do 20 damage to this guy from afar. Then do some more work out here. There we go. No problem. Sure. Quick shot into... Do I want to holster first? Yeah, holstering first is alright. We don't need to have our gun for anything else. We could quick draw, or we could right spin kick and 8 damage plus 14 kills you. So that's pretty good. But what else can we do? Sadly, I don't think we can get any bonus damage on you with what I'm thinking about. What I'm thinking about is shift and tackle to kill you in one hit. But the alternative would be something like right spin kick, swap here, and then quick draw to get 22 on you, which is okay. But it's not as exciting, and I think I would rather just kill you in one hit. Yeah. Simple as. I mean, the math just lines up too well. Now I'm just gonna make the enemies do my work for me. Man, that single change, that single simple change that makes it so that you can kill these guys off of railings. All of a sudden, tackle is just so much more practical than it used to be. Because you can just instantly kill your enemies. It's cool. I like being able to do that. It makes life that much easier. Now we're just doing something like flourish into double tap, and then maybe we can tackle him later or something, right? Yeah, like now flourish is again proving its worth. So between the base damage modifier and flourish. Now double tap is just going to be absurd. As though it weren't absurd enough already. No. No, we need more absurdity, clearly. Pity that he's alive at 1 HP, but that's not going to save him. It's only going to delay the inevitable. Sure. Yeah, absolutely. No problem. The nice thing about Shimmy is it's actually going to get my counter shot off right away, so I'm not going to have to worry about it later. Let's get that activated and sent out, and then I can holster, and I don't have to worry about the timing of that anymore. That's already taken care of. Okay. So what's this doing here, then? We're just killing you, right? Unless, this is 10 and 15 is 25. That kills you. So 25 kills you, so instead we'll quick draw you. For pretty solid damage, if I do say so myself. And would you look at that, we're already, like, way up at... We're saturating at 12 here. Like, we want more max combo. We discarded our combo in the middle of that and made it all right back up. The only person who can cheer us on for our accomplishments is our boss. And I guess the other members of Organization 11, who you, dear viewers, are presumably representing in this analogy. I don't think we need Flurry. Like, we already have 3-punch combo. We don't really need Flurry to be free. It would be amazing once we upgrade it, but, like, in principle, I guess what we would do is we would remove 3-punch combo and get Flurry, but I think we just don't need it yet. Like, this deck is working. Now that we have 4 movement cards, it's working great. Yeah, let's skip Flurry. Shoulder Throw's tempting. Don't think we need any of this stuff. Theoretically, this is one of those cards you could use to make the armor-piercing rounds we saw earlier work, but no, it's not going to work that well in this hand. Maybe you could use it to retain a quick draw, for example, and then use that next round, but I think we just don't need it. No. Honestly, that's probably for the... Like, that card in particular is probably best if you have recycling or clear the decks or whatnot active, and then you want to be discarding cards via any means necessary. Anyway, now it's exactly the same fight, except it's easier, and we have 5 momentum, so let's just try and speed through this if we can. I make no guarantees about that one way or the other, but I'll do what I can. Okay, 14 damage lined up on you. That's number Wang right there. That's Mornington Crescent. So, we're good. We're very good. We are good at what we do. And we are full of self-affirmations. Do we want to go forward or backwards or where exactly? I guess we want to be lined up with you so that we have an extra option if we need it. We'll spend 1 combo to improve our position a little bit, and maybe we can right spin kick you out of the board. Hey, would you look at that? There it is. It's almost like I know every single card that's in my deck or something. Well, we're not shooting you, but that's alright. We're just killing you, or can we do better? I think we're probably just killing you. Yeah, in fact, quick draw actually just kills you, so no matter what I do, I'm getting 1 combo out of this, so it's just, again, a question of where I want to stand. And I guess the question of where I want to stand is I want to stand where you're standing, because now I can actually move into where you are and use this thing I have called a gun to do damage. Here, damage. I could draw again. How greedy do I want to be? What'll I draw with draw? I'm going to draw a holster. What's that going to give me? It could give me anything. And I could get countershot. we'll try it. I mean, I've got three momentum just burning a hole in my pocket, begging to be used. So, much as I hate giving up all that combo, I'm gonna try it. I'm impatient. I've got places to be. I've got things to do. This'll work. Yeah, this actually works great. Okay, we'll just build our combo right back up. Do that stun first and then shoot him, and we've got three combo right there. This guy can't even believe what he's seeing. We need to now just probably just move around him. Or we could shift through him. Yeah, that's better. Good old shift. Why spend two movement cards when one will do? Then we could do something like... Don't want to flourish. No, we'll just do quick draw and then quick shot. And this, that, and the other thing, and we'll be okay. I could have quick drawed into flourish into quick shot. I think that would have worked, and that actually would have killed him. Yes, that was a slight mistake. I could have quick drawed, flourished, and quick shot, and I would have gotten the 4 extra damage. Oh well. Is okay. So, right spin kick. It's like a shove, except it does damage. And as we're seeing here, quite a lot of damage sometimes. I'm gonna say palm strike and right spin kick actually working together pretty well here. Do I want linking move? We're still in situations every now and then where we would like a little tiny bit more movement. The problem is, if we draw, then we can't draw and then do linking move. But every single other time, it's good for us, sort of. We're already slamming the combo cap as it is, though, so I don't think we really need even more combo generation. I can imagine just a case where we just draw a whole bunch of combo requirement cards, and then we just get to be sad about it, so... I think this is not the right idea. We're still in cases where we do, like, prospectively use the draw every now and then. We're not constantly at the combo cap yet. These are also amusing, but not correct. No. We need to go forward. We need to take that 6 momentum and apply directly to the forehead. And there's the forehead in question. The head man, the foreman. The overseer. Well, he kind of has us cornered a little bit. But let's see if we can do something productive. Maybe there's something more productive we can do than just taking 19 damage on purpose. I'd consider it. Like, we could do a tremendous amount of work from that position. And it is a free headbutt, as I've described that before in the past. We could just easily play all of this and then move out of the way. I like that idea. I like that idea quite a lot. I don't think there's really anything else here that makes sense, so I'm gonna do it. I'm crazy. I am, as mentioned at the very start of things, the maniac. You have messed with the wrong individual. Sadly, I don't think I can set up a tackle on you now. I think the best I've got is just letting you get shoved slightly by one of your friends. That's too bad. Also, it's kind of a pity I've drawn all this movement cards now. That means I'm not going to have them later, but oh well. I have a ridiculous amount of combo, and yeah, so you miss your turn first, then you get shoved. So next turn, if I just draw something that, oh, say for example, does 34 damage, then I should be in business. That's not quite enough, though. Let me make a slight adjustment. Since you move first, you're not moving anywhere, you move second. I'm gonna go up here. this means that next turn you're going to go right here, and I will have the option of backing up, quick drawing you, and then doing something else at range, and then I won't take additional damage. We can go berserk, but we can be slightly more productive about it. Okay, there we go. Quick draw and a quick throw gun will certainly do. We have already seen how powerful it is. We will simply demonstrate it to this guy who hasn't heard the news yet. Before we do, let's do a little bit of science. Does flourish increase throw gun damage? It gives us plus four... Wait, why does it do... Oh, I think that's a tooltip bug. We have plus two strength, and it's factoring into that tooltip somehow when it shouldn't be. So we just spent two combo to gain four damage, I think is how that worked, because we were already in gun stance. Yeah. So that's why the damage went down a little bit. Okay. Well, I think he got bored and he fell asleep. We're just gonna have to take him back to his cell. I don't think I really want any of these. Resilience is technically okay, like it does stack with the block we're already using. I think I probably don't care. Card Shredder is amusing. There are certainly some cards we might consider replacing for other cards, but at the same time, I certainly wouldn't mind just taking this entire deck to the end game and just having all of it fully upgraded. So, in that sense, Card Shredder doesn't do anything for us. I'm gonna be bold and risky, as is apparently the underlying theme of this whole run. I'm gonna take versatility, and hopefully, we'll get some actual benefit out of that. I'm going to be patient. And if we can balance patience and aggression, maybe we can get somewhere. Next time, enemies who combine patience and aggression, the ninjas. We'll see you then.